Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Do you want to experience Ubuntu without making any changes to your Windows setup? You are in the right place. Today I will show you how to install Ubuntu on VMware Workstation Pro, the easiest and safest way to run Ubuntu alongside Windows without dual booting. This means instead of installing it directly on your system, you can safely run it in a virtual machine. Okay, so let's get started. Before we begin, what you will need for this installation: a Windows 11 PC, Ubuntu ISO, VMware Workstation Pro, minimum 2 GB of RAM, minimum 20 GB of free disk space. First, we need to download the Ubuntu ISO file. So you need to open your browser, and here you need to search for Ubuntu download. And in the search result, go to the Ubuntu websites. And here you will find download 24.04.1 LTS button. Here it is clearly mentioned that this is the latest LTS version of Ubuntu. You can see for desktop, PC and laptop. LTS means long term support, which means 5 years of free security and maintenance update. Okay, so you can see the size is nearly 5.8 GB. So just click on this button and your download gets started. So it's around 6 GB of size, so this might take a few minutes depending on your internet speed. Okay, so now I have already downloaded this file earlier, so I'm going to cancel the downloading process. Okay, but once you finish downloading, you will get an ISO file like this. Now we can proceed to the next step of download the VMware Workstation Pro. So once again, open your web browser and this time head over to the VMware official websites and download the latest version of Workstation Pro for Windows from there. And nowadays, if you click on the download link, it will redirect you to the Broadcom websites. This is new, okay, and you need to download it from there. And the process has changed and you need to fill out a few steps in order to download this, okay. But don't worry, if you run into any problem, I have already made a separate video covering the entire process. And I have already given the link in the description below so that you can check from there. Okay. Once you install the VMware Workstation Pro, it will look like this. Now it's time to create our virtual machine. Okay. So for that, you need to click on create a new virtual machine. You can choose either typical or custom wizard. If you are a new user, I recommended setting the first option. Okay. Which is typical recommended. And then click on next. The new virtual machine wizard window will launch. Here you will have three options. You need to click on the I will install the operating system later option and then click next. Now you need to select the guest operating system. Click on the Linux radio button and under the version pick Ubuntu 64 bit from the drop down list. Okay, then click on next. And here give your virtual machine a name. This name is not fixed and can be any name of your choice. Okay, so I'm going to name it Ubuntu 24.04. Additionally, you can also change the location of the virtual machine if you want, otherwise leave it as is. And then click on next. And here in specify disk capacity, you need to specify the amount of hard disk space the virtual machine can use. So I'm going to make it 50 GB or you can leave the default setting as is, that is 20 GB. And according to your system specification, you can reduce or increase the space. Okay. And also keep the split virtual disks into multiple file options checked and hit next. Then click on finish to create the virtual machine. And now in the left pane, you will see your Ubuntu 24.04 is ready. And before we power on the virtual machine, we need to configure a few things in the settings. Okay, so to do that, click on Edit Virtual Machine Settings before starting the VM. Okay. Once the virtual machine setting page will open, select memory in the left pane. And here you need to specify the amount of memory of your virtual machine. And you can adjust this based on your system available memory. A minimum of 2 GB is recommended, but 4 GB or more will provide better performance. Okay. And set number of processor as per your availability. Okay. And in the hard disk sections, we have already selected the amount of space earlier. So leave this as it is. Then comes to the CD DVD SATA options. And select use ISO image file. Then click browse and select the Ubuntu ISO file that we have downloaded earlier. And finally click on open. Then click OK to save the changes. The newly created Ubuntu 24.04 virtual machine will appear in the virtual machine list on the left side. You need to click on start button to start up this guest operating system. Okay. The Ubuntu installer will boot up. And you will see the Ubuntu grab menu will appear. So highlight the try or install Ubuntu options and press enter. The Ubuntu installer will launch. You may need to wait few minutes until it finishes the installation process. Okay. Select your preferred language. By default, it will be English, and click Next. Again, click on Next. Select your keyboard layout. Select English US. Just click on the Next button and proceed. In the Internet option, select your connection type, whether wired or Wi-Fi. Then click on Next. What do you want to do with Ubuntu? Install Ubuntu or try Ubuntu. Select install Ubuntu and click on next. And in the type of installation, how would you like to install Ubuntu? You need to select interactive installation and then click on next. And in the application, what apps would you like to install? You need to select default selection, then click on next. And in optimize your computer option, select install third-party software for graphics and Wi-Fi hardware, and also select download and install support for additional media formats. After that, click on next. And in the disk setup, select erase disks and install Ubuntu. Don't worry, this only affects the virtual machine, not your main system. Okay. And then click on next. On the next screen, you need to create your account, and here you need to enter your name. So I'm going to name it Tech InfoCard, and in computer name I will keep the same name. Okay. And same in username also. If you want, you can change it in your own way, and also put the password for the Ubuntu system. And again, you need to re-enter password to verify, then click on next. And here you need to select your time zone accordingly if it was not selected automatically. Okay. Now you can review your choices, and after that click on install. Now Ubuntu will start the installation process. The Ubuntu installer will begin copying files on the virtual machine disk. The entire process will take a few minutes, so you need to wait until it finishes. Once the installation is complete, you will be prompted to restart the virtual machine. So click on restart now. And after reboot, Ubuntu will again load. And after a while, you will see a message that please remove the installation media, then press enter. So when the message will appear, you need to hit the enter key. After few seconds, I can see my username display over here. So click on my username, and here I need to provide my password, which I have created during installation. Okay. After that, this will log you into the Ubuntu operating system. And you will be greeted by the Welcome to Ubuntu 24.04.1 LTS screen. And here you need to click on Next to proceed through the initial setup. And on the Ubuntu Pro screen, click on Skip for now and then click on Next. On the Help Improve Ubuntu screen, select Don't Share System Data and click Next. And finally, click on Finish. Congratulations, you now have Ubuntu running on your Windows 11 machine using VMware Workstation Pro. So take some time to explore this new environment. And if you want, you can click on the Show Apps button to see all the available applications on Ubuntu. And you can customize it according to your needs. If you want to make this full screen, you need to just click on the Full Screen button in the VMware toolbar. And it will expand to cover your entire screen. Okay. And if you want to power up the virtual machine, simply click on the power icon in the top right corner of the Ubuntu desktop and select power off. This will close the Ubuntu session and power up the virtual machine without affecting your host system. Okay, so that's it for today's video, guys. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more tech tutorials. If you have any question or run into any issue, leave a comment below. And I will do my best to help you out. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.